Welcome to Kickstart, where you get to see new products here at Automation Direct. Well, today I'm going to show you our new line extension of stainless steel proximity sensors. We're now offering more flush style sensors and now non-flush style stainless steel proximity sensors. These are a full stainless steel body, meaning the barrel and the sensing face are made of 316L stainless. Now, have you heard or used the term shielded and unshielded instead of flush or non-flush? Well, they have basically the same meaning. The difference between a flush and a non-flush sensor is that a flush sensor can be mounted flush or embedded in a ferrous material and will not pick up or detect its surroundings, only what's in front of it. Whereas a non-flush sensor cannot be mounted inside or embedded inside a ferrous material. It must extend past the face, so it would have to be like this, so it does not pick up the metal from the side. Now we have two new 8mm flush with M8 and M12 quick disconnect models. We have two new 12mm flush and non-flush with M12 quick disconnect connectors. And we have three new 18mm flush and non-flush with M12 connectors. And last, we have three new 30mm flush and non-flush models, all with M12 connectors. Now, these are all low-cost and high-performance models. The metal face is great for extreme environments. They have LED status indicators and are very visible all the way around. The stainless lock nuts are included, and we have a wide selection of NPN or PNP styles. Now, these sensors all have lifetime limited warranties. You can find the agency approvals and the specs for these stainless steel metal sensors on our website at AutomationDirect.com. And don't forget, we sell inductive proximity sensors in barrel style and rectangular, as well as photo sensors, capacitive sensors, ultrasonic sensors, and more. And don't forget about our huge sensor cable selection. Now check back with us often on Automation Direct's websites or on youtube.com/automationdirect for more Kickstart videos. And if you're watching with us today on YouTube, please let us know what you think about these sensors or how you plan to use these sensors in your next application by dropping us a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and we hope to see you again soon.